Okay, so I'm just going to read from the mustard seed now. Mustard seed. Commentary, a running commentary on the apocryphal book of Thomas. One of the books that they left out. Left out of the good book, right? They left a lot of books out. Anyway, such is life. We'll be listening to Entre Dos Aguas, Between Two Waters, by Paco de Lucia, provided by MRICO MRICO 51. Okay. A man who doubts cannot move innocently. Before he moves, he will think. And sometimes he will think so much that the opportunity is lost. That is why thinkers never do much. They cannot act. They become simply cerebral. Because before action, they must decide. They must come to a conclusion. And they cannot come to a conclusion, so how can they act? Then it is better to wait and not to act. But life will not wait for you. Or you become faithful, believing, a blind man. Then anybody, any politician, any madman, any pope, any priest can lead you anywhere. But they themselves are blind. And when the blind lead the blind, there is bound to be catastrophe. What to do? Ordinary reasoning says, make a compromise. One scientist, B.F. Skinner, did an experiment worth remembering. A white mouse was the object of experiment. The white mouse was starved for 2 or 3 days, so it was very hungry. Eh? Very hungry. It was just hunger, ready to jump and eat anything available. Then it was put on a platform. Just below the platform, there were two similar boxes. The same color, same size, and both boxes contained food. The white mouse could jump in either the right box or the left. The mouse immediately jumped. Not even a single moment of thought. But whenever he jumped into the right box, he would get an electric shock. And there was a trap door, so he would fall inside another box through the trap door and would not be able to reach the food. Whenever he jumped into the left box, there was no shock and there was no trap door, so he would reach the food. Within 2 or 3 days, he learned the trick. He would jump in the left box and avoid the right. Right? Then Skinner made a change. He changed the places of the boxes. The mouse jumped into the left box and found that there was an electric shock. Now it was disturbed, confused as to what to do and what not to do. So before jumping, it would tremble and waver, doubtful. This is how a philosopher is. A white little mouse. A little white mouse, trembling, doubtful, what to do, left or right, how to choose, and who knows? But then it got accustomed again. Then Skinner again made a change. The mouse became so confused that although it was hungry, it would wait, trembling, looking at this box and that and how to decide. Then he decided the thing you have decided. He jumped between the two boxes, but there was no food. This was not going to help. And after a few weeks of experiment, the white mouse became mad, neurotic. This is what is happening to us. We have become confused. What to do? What not to do? And the only thing that comes to mind is that it is difficult to choose this, difficult to choose that. Then it is better to make a compromise. Just jump in the middle. But there is no food in the middle. Of course, there is no electric shock, but there is no food either. None. None food. None food anywhere. No food anywhere. No food to be found. You miss life if you jump in the middle. If it were possible for the white mouse to mount both boxes, he would have done that, don't you think? These are the two possibilities which open for reasoning. Mount both horses or just jump in the middle. Intelligence. A very penetrating and keen intelligence is needed to understand the problem. There is no other solution. I'm not going to give you any solution. No Yeshua has given any solution to anybody. Just the understanding of the problem is the solution. You understand the problem, and the problem disappears. That was a nice reading. So now, all I have to do is understand the problem, and then the problem will disappear. Right? Right. Acha. But I think I've got it now. Yes. But how long will this realization last? Should I be worried?